Hey guys, Andy here, and today on Andy Talks Navy, I'm going to be celebrating my 2-year anniversary of getting out of the U.S. Navy. On September 24th, 2015, I received my DD-214, which is my official discharge from the U.S. military. And from there, I caught a flight back home to Saline, Ohio to begin preparations for going up here to Kalamazoo, Michigan to start my life over again as a college student and to get that degree. But it wasn't really that easy. One of the things that I had to get used to again was life in America. Having been stationed in Japan for over 2 years, I had gotten used to just the way that the Japanese people do things. I had gotten used to their unfailing politeness. And coming back to the States, where not everybody wants to be the best at their job, they're just kind of there to get a paycheck, come off as rude in some cases, was a bit of a reverse culture shock getting used to that again. And that's not just an American thing, but that's also a civilian thing as well. Because in the military, you're always trying to do the best to make the next rank and to get that next qualification and to just progress in your military career. And even though I wasn't like super Joe Navy, charge forward kind of person when I was in the military, I still had some sense of pride in what I did. Pride in my work, pride in my equipment, pride in my spaces. And it took me a while to kind of calm down from that like perfectionist lifestyle. And I still struggle with it from time to time, even at work especially. And so in addition to coming back to America after 2 years abroad, and not only coming back to America, but coming back to America as a civilian, another thing that I had to get used to was being a college student again. Keep in mind, I hadn't been in college since 2007. It was hard for me to get back into that student mindset of setting aside time to study for tests. Doing homework was a big thing for me because I hate doing stuff that I don't like to do at home. Now, if I'm actually at school, I'm like super focused and can do stuff. But like when I come here, like my attention's all over the place and I can't focus on homework. I also had to deal with transferring schools and changing majors. When I first got out here to Kalamazoo, my original major was in computer information systems. It seemed like a very logical major. Working with computers, working in the business sector is kind of a mashup of those two industries. And I figured, well, that's a pretty reasonable degree to have. I can get a nice paying job and, you know, have something to fall back on if this whole like Japan thing doesn't work out and I need to come back to America for some reason, or if I can't get a job in Japan and need one here in the States. But I didn't like the classes. There's a lot of math courses that I was having problems with. In addition to that, I was also dealing with the whole reverse culture shock and all the other stuff I talked about earlier. So it was pretty much a recipe for disaster, and my grades suffered because of it. One day, I decided to just sit down, reevaluate what I'm doing in college because I didn't want to drop out of yet another college and to miss this opportunity that I'd worked 5 years to get. So I told myself, you know what, ultimately I just need the degree. It doesn't really matter what I'd get the degree in, despite what some people may say. All I really need is the paper. So I decided to bet on myself and to change my major to film production. I saw a pretty quick turnaround with my grades. The classes became more interesting. But the second semester rolled around and I wanted to take a bunch of easy classes so I can get my GPA back up again so I can transfer to be a bit closer to my friends and family in Ohio. So I just took a bunch of really easy classes. The thing was, it was like too easy for me. So I ended up losing interest and my grades slipped again. So I had to reevaluate myself and decided to transfer over to community college. It's actually a much better fit for what I want to get into with film production. Much more contemporary. I guess I could say, because the classes I was taking over at Western were more in like traditional media, you know, like films and television and stuff like that. But the stuff that I'm taking over at the local community college, they're more geared towards new media. There's still like traces of old media, just to kind of see where that fits into the current version of media that's out there today. And so where do I want to go from here? Basically, I just want to get my associates from my community college and then transfer over to another college to finish out my four-year degree. And then from there, see if anybody's hiring out in Japan and try to get a job out there so I can go back to Japan. I really enjoyed Japan a lot, even though I was going through a lot of dark, troubling times out there as well, something I'm going to be getting into in a future video. I really enjoyed Japan a lot, so even during my off time, like on the weekends and stuff, I would go out to Tokyo and just visit the sites so I could, you know, do filming and stuff. And then during the week, I would edit those episodes of Andy Japandy. I'd also like hang out with my friends, go to bars, izakaya, clubs, stuff like that. And it was just a lot of fun. I miss everybody terribly out there. A lot of expats, when they come back to their home country for whatever reason, they're often very excited and it seems like their life is well put together now. And it's like Japan is just some far off thing in the distance. You know, it's just almost like a former life. I feel like there's still more for me to do out in Japan, and I feel like I'd only just begun to scratch the surface. Out here in America, aside from getting my degree, there's really not a whole lot out here for me. You know, I don't have wife, kids, none of that stuff. Of course, I still have my family and friends, but, you know, my friends got spouses and kids of their own, so they're plenty busy with that and full-time jobs. I've definitely gone through a lot of personal growth in these 2 years since getting out of the Navy. A lot of it has been setbacks, frustration, readjustments, failure, whatever you want to call it. I'm beginning to see some glimmer of success with these setbacks. And even though there's sometimes parts of me that wish that I just would have lost the weight, sucked it in, went to FEP, laid off the pizza and booze, and just stayed in the Navy until my EOS at least. There's also another part of me that's like, I wouldn't have gotten to this point had I decided to stay in. I might be in a much different position. I may not have been able to meet the people that I've met since getting out of the Navy. It's a wild thing to think about sometimes. And even though I don't live a super exciting life like I used to when I was in the Navy and you hit all these ports and make all these videos, I still am seeing, you know, progress and change in my personality and change in my mental health for the positive now. I'm still gotta work on the upkeep to keep the positive attitude going. Things are beginning to move in the right direction for me now. And with that said, this is the Andy-san, signing up for now here at Andy Talks Navy HQ. And as always, we'll see you next time. Bye, guys. Be sure to like and subscribe. Bye.